Welcome back to where it all started. It's been nearly 5 years since CBBC first came to Conyers School and met an amazing group of Year 7s. They made us laugh.
Do you want to be my special friend?
I've just had my lips done.
They made us cry.
It'll always be like in the back of my mind.
And they made us feel a bit ill. But the old Year 7 are now Year 11. And this is their final term. They're all cramming for exams and planning for their future. So I won't get to teach them anymore. That's tragic, that. It's time for them to say goodbye to our school. Our old Year 7s are weeks away from their GCSEs, but they've still got me looking out for them.
So, you've got 3 science subjects, which leaves you with 10 lessons until your exam.
There are only 5 school weeks left. You know, the time is now.
Year 11 is our last year together, saying goodbye to everybody, like, deciding where we want to go to next, and, of course, our GCSEs are coming up.
It's a rough idea of how many marks are available in the exam.
Right now, there is a lot of pressure.
You need to hurry and link all your pictures together. All right? So that should be your main meal one. That one should be your dessert.
The workload doesn't come on gradually. It comes on all at once.
T minus 1, and then that equals...
Right, so it's going to lose one. That's fair enough.
Things definitely feel more real now. It's very daunting sort of thing. It's like, whoa.
Overwhelming.
Yeah, overwhelming. That's the word.
We're going to revisit structure and bonding.
I wouldn't like to relive this year. No. Every other year I relive, but not this one. Not this one.
The carefree life of Year 7 seems a long time ago.
5 years ago, we were in Year 7. 5 years ago, we were filming the first ever our school. A lot has happened.
I enjoyed Year 7 a lot more than I'm enjoying Year 11.
Our students are making big decisions about their futures and getting ready to bid farewell to our very familiar school.
It is going to be like saying goodbye to people that you like, you might be close to, and never seeing them again.
In a way, it's like the end. And it's just going to be nothing like what you've just done for the past 5 years.
Apart from all the scary stuff, the other big thing on everyone's mind is the end of year prom. This is where the whole year group will say goodbye to each other, whilst looking fabulous, of course. Here's someone who may have an opinion on that.
Prom is just such a big thing now, it's kind of just gone full, sort of like blown out of proportion.
Since way back in Year 7, Libby's always been keen on her fashion.
Probably got about 12 pairs of shoes.
Hi.
But today is the big challenge, finding the perfect prom dress.
Obviously, I really wanted to find a nice dress for myself because it's quite a big day, like, you want to look nice.
There's loads.
Luckily, she's got her mum and Chloe to help her out.
I quite like the back of it, like I like how it like goes down and then the bow on the back, it's really nice.
Yeah, that colour definitely would suit you.
I started looking 6 months before purely because there were so many people that had already started looking for their dresses and I just thought, you know, I need to kind of get in quick to kind of see how I feel in different dresses. Gorgeous. And what suits me.
So no, really, I feel like I need to find one a bit more wow than this.
Yeah.
Now, I reckon there's a bit of a gender gap when it comes to prom prep.
It's definitely different for the boys and the girls because the girls have already planned out everything they're doing on that night and I haven't thought about it yet.
It's nice, isn't it?
It's elegant as well.
The lads just, they always have it easier than girls if you think about it. They can literally just have to buy a suit, sort their ride out, they're done.
That one's 475.
Which one's that one?
People will be paying like £600, £700 for a dress, which is crazy.
535, that one.
I was hoping to spend like maybe 50 quid, 60 quid.
Yeah.
That's quite nice, though, isn't it?
I like that one. I like the detail on it.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, that's beautiful. Gorgeous.
Yeah. I love it. It's so nice.
Hang on. I think we may have a keeper.
I'm so glad we finally found it after all this time.
So am I.
just when I had it on, I just knew that that was the dress that I loved.
Now, here's a student who's already scored his dream job. Back in year seven, Nathan was all about the football.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how much I like football, probably a definite 10.
And he was desperate to get into the school footy team.
Oh, yes! Getting!
Ever since I was, like, a kid, just you want to play football, don't you? It's just something you want to do.
Things are a bit different now. Nathan's been signed for a scholarship by Middlesbrough Football Club.
I got picked up by Borough Academy and then played a few times for England.
Yep, you heard that right. Nathan's been playing for the England under-16 team.
When I played for England, I was nervous, really nervous, because, like, your family's watching and it's, like, a big deal, like, what you dream about doing.
To Nathan's old teammates, this is going to take some getting used to.
To see I was playing football with him in the backfield when we were, like, 8, 9, 10, and then to see what he's done, it's crazy.
He's going to live the dream of every 11-year-old boy, I guess.
Nathan's come a long way since the Year 7 football team.
Got a big chance. Just got to do your best and, like, see where you end up.
The end of term means many students going their separate ways. But here's a pair who will definitely be staying together. In year 10, the twins were embracing their differences.
She's blonde, and I'm not.
But this year, I reckon they're more alike again.
Wait, I've actually lost her face.
Our hair's similar again now. We're similar, but with slight differences. It's not just that we've got the same, like, hair colour now. We're also thinking about going down the same, like, career path.
Yep, the twins have decided on the same career, studying hair and beauty at the same academy.
Hi.
Hi. Hi.
The academy runs its own salon, so the twins have come for a taster.
So this is where you'll be doing all your practical training.
Hairdressing, you can take it as an art, or you can just take it as snipping hair.
So I'm just going to show you how to curl. So if you twist the hair around the straighteners and pull down just nice and slowly.
You'd be creative if you want with it. And we're, like, creative people. So I think it's a good, like, career choice for us.
And then you can see it just gives a nice curl.
If you want to do it in fashion, you want to do it for photo shoots, you've got to actually, like, put in that extra training. Go on, Chloe. Take a seat. No, it's not work. I can't do it.
Do you want me to have a go?
Yeah.
So let's check. Straighteners in. Wrap it round.
You didn't wrap it
round.
Oh,
I didn't wrap it round twice.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So what's the end goal then, girls?
I feel like I could probably imagine us, like, opening a salon as a business together.
You two running a salon? Oh, call it Twins Trims.
What do you think of it, Chloe? Can you see it?
Yeah.
We can both rely on each other. We both know each other's strengths and weaknesses.
Yeah, I actually like it.
It's actually really good. Basically, she can't fire me and I can't fire her.
I'm surprised, Holly. You've done well.
She secretly loves working with me. She doesn't say it, but she does.
I think it's quite cool that my entire school life has been recorded through our school.
Looking back at it, it's mad. Not many people have had the chance to obviously get filmed, whatever, make their own series.
A song on the radio, but it don't sound the same.
You see just literally not how much you've grown up, not just physically, but mentally.
If anything, it's just really embarrassing.
This is the heaviest thing in the world.
Like, looking back at everything and how squeaky our voices were.
Well, everyone does call me a nerd.
I'll be able to remember my school life very well, and a lot of other people that I meet will be able to laugh at it when I show them.
Right, you got it? Good lad.
It would just be amazing to, like, you know, show your kids in the future and say, like, this is what I was like.
Yay!
Like, I can't imagine my parents at all being at school.
Okay, Luca, tu commences.
Quoi, quoi?
I mean, if my dad showed me a TV show when he was 11, I'd be thinking, eh.
Oh, pourquoi?
Plenty of our students might be leaving us, but you don't have to go. Somebody who's not quite ready to say goodbye is Delight.
Je m'appelle, je m'appelle. Delight, we show what's on. J'ai onze ans. Salut, salut.
In year 11, Delight's made a big decision about her future.
I think I'm gonna stay here at Conyers and I'm gonna do English literature, psychology, and biology. Guys, this is neutrons, right?
Neutrons.
So it's gonna give this one to make. Do you know what I get this? I've always liked the aspect of like, helping people. I've always wanted to be like a doctor.
Dr. Delight. And staying on lets her access the hidden part of the school, our sixth form.
No one's really allowed in there unless you're a sixth former. So like most of my year has never really been in there.
Hi. Good morning.
Luckily, Delight's friend Safia is already in year 13, so she can give some hints on sixth form life.
Oh, so, have you got a full day today?
No, I only have 2 lessons.
Oh, so lucky. I wish I had 2 lessons. She's been able to, like, go there and tell me how it's like, tell me if she likes it or not, and that has, like, influenced my decision. Oh, I can't believe you don't have to wear school uniform. Like, I'm so jealous. I like to express myself in, like, the clothes I wear, so I've never really liked school uniforms. So I feel like, obviously, like, being able to wear my own clothes is going to be, like, a big step.
So on the first floor up here is the sixth form room.
The only bad thing about it is that you have to walk up these stairs every day.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
I can't believe you got a telly.
I know. Sometimes, like, we put, like, the music channel on or the news.
Oh.
So it's nice to just relax when you come up here after a lesson.
It feels like way more grown up, I feel like.
I know, the transition from like school to sixth form, it's really quick, but you fit right in after a while.
Yeah.
And there are some definite advantages to our sixth form.
You're still around, you're like the teachers that you're comfortable with, but it's still different, like you've got like the best of all.
Do you think you're gonna like it here then?
Yeah.
I think you'll enjoy it.
We're happy to have you stay on, Delight. See you next year. Some students are planning for futures much further afield. When we first met him, Lucas was... well, I'll let him explain.
Back in year 7, I think I was more of what you would call a stick.
Oh, Maggie's thirsty then.
But by year 10, Lucas was putting me to shame with his fitness regime.
I've got to this point just because I wanted to, and I wanted to hard enough that I could change myself.
And in year 11, he's taking on a new challenge as part of the local army cadets.
I think I like cadets because it's very disciplined.
Quick march. Bang straight and left. Turn.
Your uniform needs to be perfect. You need to make sure that you polish your boots, you do your beret. You do really want to be very accurate with what you're doing and get everything right.
It's more than just a hobby for Lucas.
I think the cadets are also a really good cause. It will help you get a job in the army. I would want to progress to an officer.
I think we're looking at a man with a plan.
I'm always dead set on what I want to do and for what I need to do to get there.
Eyes front. Great. Stand at ease.
Yep, Lucas knows what he wants. But our next student has shown time and again that the future is what you make it. For Harry, who has cerebral palsy, secondary school was always going to be a challenge. But I don't think I've ever met a more unstoppable young man. Last time we saw him, Harry was organising his own bake sales. And now he's decided to train as a chef at Middlesbrough College.
I was excited going to the college, but I thought it might be a lot different to Conyers.
Today, he's visiting the college kitchen to get a taste of his future.
Hi, Harry, how are you doing? Nice
good,
to meet
good, you.
Here to do some starters on lunch service, I hear. Okay, have you ever made a risotto before?
No.
Perfect. Okay. We start heating it up in the pan.
It was really good to be in the kitchen.
Boom. Right, there you go, Harry. One risotto in order. Right. Okay, so exactly what I just showed you. Yeah. Let's go for it. Yeah?
It was just a great environment to work in for the first time.
That's it. A bit more. That's it. Keep it stirring.
Yeah.
There you go, fella. Lovely.
I reckon Harry's got his future all figured out.
My dream career would be opening up a cafe or a restaurant of my own and just creating food for the public.
That's it.
These last 5 years have been massive for this lad.
I feel like I've grown up a lot, like physically and mentally. When I was born, I was told that I would never walk.
Top man. Well done. Yeah, on to a winner.
But I obviously proved him wrong, so I'm here and I'm ready to go on to the next level of life.
All right, nice one. Well done, Harry. Thank you very much.
The future. It's where we're all heading, Harry. But first things first, you've got a prom to get to. Right across town, final preparations are being made.
I always remember you as this little baby, but now you're growing.
I like how you've done your eyes. It's got a little bit of golden as well.
Yeah.
All grown up.
Excited?
Yeah.
You look fab.
Look good. Okay.
You think you lot look posh? Take a look at me.
How do I look? Yes! Do I look smart? Do you like my bow tie?
Right, everybody ready? It's prom time.
Feels it like an end of an era. I think we've all started to realise that it is real, we are leaving, so we're all trying to like make the most of it.
We've struggled for 5 years to get here and we've all been through so much. We've all had such happy moments.
You've got through it with all these other people that are feeling obviously the same.
Every day it's just to say goodbye to some people. Even the people like you haven't really spoke to, it's just like you've been a year for 5 years, so say goodbye to them.
Oh, you're gorgeous.
You're gonna miss a lot of people that you see day in, day out.
Say cheese.
And it's just like a massive family, I feel.
Come on, guys, we get to the party.
I am so proud of you lot, but this is it. Time to say goodbye to our school.
I've loved every minute of it. Definitely memories and experience I think we'll take on for like the rest of our lives.
Everyone always says, don't know, it flies by, it's the best time of your life and stuff, but I never ever thought it would be, but it really hasn't. I just want to go back to year seven.
Just really excited for what's going to happen because I don't really know.
In the future, there's going to be a lot of opportunities, a lot of things I haven't tried before, and I'm really happy about that. And I can't wait to just like do all those things that I haven't done.